climate has always made life challenging here in Africa's Sahel region between the Sahara Desert and the equator. While the rest of the world debates the future impact of a 1.5 to 2 degrees Celsius temperature increase, most of Africa's Sahel countries have already passed through this climate change threshold. Many scientists believe it to be the tipping point for traditional life here.
The Sahel has always been the battleground between man and the desert. So people living in the Sahel have always lived in very precarious environments.
Gernot Laganda leads the World Food Program's Climate Risk Reduction Team. He knows how immediate climate risks are here.
A big difference that we see is that the weather patterns that people have accustomed to over generations are becoming much more unpredictable.
More frequent and prolonged droughts and flash flooding from untimely and often extreme rainfall makes farming harder for these countries that depend mostly on agriculture. This sub-Sahara region from Somalia and Sudan in the east to Nigeria and Mali in West Africa is home for the majority of the world's most severe hunger crises.
For WFP, climate change is a humanitarian issue. We are regularly called to respond to extreme food emergencies, food crises that can be triggered by conflict as much as climate-related disasters.
There is growing evidence of food insecurity being a major contributor to instability and armed conflicts here and in other places around the world.
Climate changes can undermine economic development, and low economic development is a well-associated risk factor for conflict.
Josh Busby, a research professor at the University of Texas, develops country risk assessment rankings for USAID and other international organizations. Based on recent climate, economic, political, and stability conditions, several Sahel countries are in the top 10 of the world's least stable countries.
Because they're fragile governments that when they're exposed to climate hazards and are subject to other kinds of security problems at the same time, they're ill-equipped to be able to handle those problems simultaneously.
Changing climate conditions are also contributing to the perfect storm of growing terrorist threats in Mali, Niger, and Chad, where the American military has forward deployed more troops and trainers than anywhere else in Africa.
The climate and environment challenge on the continent really do start to contribute to security challenges.
General Thomas Waldhauser, head of American military forces in Africa, and other senior military officials believe the increasing food security and migration problems are making it easier for terrorist groups to attract displaced young men.
Some of the groups in the northern Mali, Niger area there, you know, they leverage these challenges to recruit because they really are after influence and they want to maintain their livelihood.
Spikes in precipitation, both too much and too little, which are commonly associated with changing climate conditions, can be directly correlated with spikes in migration. Combine that with the Sahel's dependence on agriculture and its chronic problems of poverty, population growth, and lack of any infrastructure for dealing with these issues. More people who depend on the land to live have no other choice than to leave.
Today, in the farm, the products cannot, it's insufficient and cannot permit to serve all of the family members.
Thierno Diallo and his family back in his native Guinea had always been farmers until the changing climate forced him to leave. Like other young men, unable to support themselves or their families, he was willing to risk the treacherous desert crossing to North Africa and across the Mediterranean in search of work now that agriculture was no longer an option.
I know today the ocean is being seen as an open grave for many people. Dying in the ocean is not something that they fear. They are not fearful of that because they have that in their mind that I'm already dead. Why would I fear death anymore?
Eli Keita, the country director in Niger for CARE International, has seen communities abandoned and armed conflicts erupt between farmers and herders, all competing for scarcer, usable land. An estimated 300,000 people throughout the Sahel have been displaced.
I didn't decide to come back, but based on the situation on the ground, where it's quite difficult to survive.
Tierno Diallo made it as far north as Algeria before being sent back to Niger, along with these other young men, now stranded in this International Organization for Migration facility in Agadez, Niger, waiting to be repatriated by their respective countries. The UN organization is also teaching Tierno and other migrants more resilient farming practices to make it possible for them to return to farming in their home countries.
People need to adopt new techniques for farming. They need to adapt new ways of living their life so that they can adapt to the reality of climate change. Because it's real in our lives. We live it every day.
Unable to change the climate or generate enough aid for dealing with the growing humanitarian crises, major humanitarian groups like the World Food Program and CARE are working with local farmers to make their fields and crops more drought and flood resistant. They are developing new seed stocks for shorter and more erratic growing seasons.
For them to be able to get the seeds and farming inputs that they need, CARE has organized them, especially the women, into village saving and loan association groups, where they save at a certain time of the year and start lending to each other from that saving for small loans that they pay back.
I think one of the most effective solutions to help local communities adapt to climate change is to help organize smallholder farmers into groups that have access to finance, that have access to technology, that have access to know-how.
The future climate hazards may be well outside the experience that they've seen before, and so the kinds of humanitarian emergencies that are familiar to us might be even greater than what we've seen in the past.
What I would say to the people who do not believe in the fallout of climate change is that there are some people who are already living the impact of climate change. It's not something 50 years down the road. It's here with us.
For the PBS NewsHour, Mike Cerre in Africa's Sahel region.